Hey everybody, and welcome to DF41. 大家好. Yeah, that was my attempt at saying hello everybody in Chinese. So what is this? This is basically a 3D visualizer and simulator of the Dangfang For1 Road Mobile Intercontinental Ballistic Missile. So we're basically nuking somebody today. That is what this game is about. And I'm wondering, is this a loading screen or... Is something supposed to happen? Oh, we can actually move. Okay, that's interesting. So that is a game. There's no loading screen and we can jump like... Okay, that's not jumping, that's literally flying. So that game is in early access. It's actually completely free. It was released 1 month ago on Steam. Free to play. And it is a simulator of the Chinese nuclear missile device thingy, I think. So let's test it out. First of all, this is probably the tutorial, which is nice. That looks like a screenshot from the Windows 10 on-screen keyboard. So we have 2, 3, and... I'm not sure. Alright, there is an explanation. So we can raise the missile, and J and U. What does that do? Oh, that looks not complicated at all. Huawei, that's what? When presented as a notification device, type Huawei as a passcode. Okay, that's important to know. There's even support, interesting. So our goal right now is to nuke somebody, exactly. Helicopter and tank are now drivable and flyable. So you can fly the tank? I hope not. Be kinda unrealistic. And where are we even? It looks like some sort of desert. It's probably, yeah, that's definitely China. I mean, it wouldn't, yeah, that, no, you know what, this is the United States, of course. So, yeah. I mean, the elephant in the room is obviously that thing there, but before we activate it, let's try other things out. When we can jump, we can do Castlevania double jumps. That is amazing, and that is a bit, the screen is a bit weird. Anyway, okay, can we enter it, GTA style? So after playing Microsoft Flight Simulator, you know, I thought, why not play something more exciting for a change? And that is definitely up the alley. How can we enter? I'm pressing all buttons, but I just can't enter it for the love of it. So back to the tutorial it is then. What is this strange sound, by the way? Oh, I wonder how big is the world actually? Because if we are shooting this missile, it should probably not be on next to our doorstep, you know? Okay, let's read it again. I actually don't think there's any sort of menu in this game, so what you see is literally what you get. There's nothing else. It's just us running around, and this is the menu. Let's read it. So we can enter and exit with E. Interesting choice of keys. We can raise the missile tube. Okay, but you must be inside to do that. And we can start a countdown with T. And time to launch, much more realistic launch effect is coming on July, but this is August, so it's already probably there. A helicopter and tank are now drivable. To fly helicopter, approach and press E, which makes sense because it's enter-exit. And press spacebar to raise the height. Okay, and left control to lower altitude, E to exit. Sounds reasonable, let's try it out. Where's the first thing we can enter? Yeah, this helicopter looks nice. But this is what we will try first. I mean, don't worry, we will shoot the missile eventually. But first, I want to try stuff out. And press... Oh! What was that? Yeah, we... Oh, this is literal GTA. That is how I remember it. Can we shoot this? Oh, we can't shoot! What? We can't actually shoot! That's so disappointing. Why do we need a tank if we can't shoot, you know? It's kinda the whole point of it, isn't it? Or can we press T? T, maybe? Oh, no, wrong button. Go back, inside. I hope it doesn't have hitboxes and things like that. I don't want us to explode. maybe Q, J, U. No, it's definitely not shooting regardless of what I do. So anyway, let's leave that thing. And let's try the helicopter out. You know what, we can try that later. Let's do the most important thing right from the start. Let's actually launch something nuclear here. And what about that shadow there? That black dot. Oh, and something is flying. I wonder, does China even have aircrafts like that? That looks kind of American, but... Wow, that is actually... That is exactly what I wanted to do in Microsoft Flight Simulator. Exactly this, you know? Yeah, maybe they will patch that in or something. So, finally, we will enter our nuclear device, nuclear car or whatever. That is Dangfang 41, I think. Yes, DF-41. Can you... It drives, that's great, I think. Ooh, and it drives, it's really fast. That's actually scary, because once that thing is so fast, it's not easy to stop that. Oh, it actually, it has great brakes, actually. Now, we press T, I think. You know what? I will go back, because I have a bad feeling. I have a feeling that we need the tutorial. The manual that's printed, that's conveniently printed on the runway, should be of great help for us. Now, we need to get it in vertical position. I think we press T. No? U? J? Oh, that isn't good. I think I removed something. Let's not nuke ourselves, probably. Okay, what? Ah, okay. This does something. I don't know what, though. Let's read it again. Enter the DF-41 vehicle must be near cabin doors to enter. That's okay. Race R with R. We race with R the missile tube. And then P is the countdown. Okay, password is Huawei. Good password, by the way. Great password choice. So R will race... Ooh, that's fast rating there. Can we somehow move the camera to actually admire our... No, we can't raise the camera. That's unfortunate. Right, now, what do we do? I think we press U. Oh, you see that? There's the cap. That thing we blasted that off. Anyway, it's blasted off now, and now now it changed to the proper rocket that's inside. Let's press T for countdown. And now we're outside for some reason? Right, because we probably need to be outside for that thing to work. Yeah, these things are retracted. That looks good so far. Everything's alright. We're ready to go, but I wonder who are we... Oh, no, let's not do that. So the activation code is Huawei. Right? Correct. But who are we nuking? I think I am... He should probably leave this place. Yeah, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Yeah, just shoot it. Well, we can have a rocket camera in a moment. Oh, that is actually amazing, but... Is that all? What is going on? Press X to switch camera. Oh, whatever is going on, it's flying somewhere. Oh, we can actually see the whole planet from above. That's quite a small planet if you think about that, and it's flying insanely fast. But who are we nuking is the question. It looks surprisingly like what? I have no idea what country is that even. Bangladesh? Why are we nuking Bangladesh? There's no reason to do that. They haven't done anything to us. And another interesting detail is because normally when you shoot a rocket, you would shoot it prograde, you know, with the rotation of the planet, I thought, but you're here just shoot it however you want. What? Okay, that doesn't look right. Can we go back? Well, the game is certainly early access, so that was to be expected. Now. What is going on? Okay, I think we destroyed the planet. Yeah, that is how the end will look for our known universe. I don't know. I think we created some sort of black hole and fell inside it. Or something like that. Okay, let's actually... We could explore it with a helicopter, you know? Maybe we'll see something in this strange world that we have found ourselves in. Yeah, that is very weird. Everything about Huawei. Does Huawei create helicopters? I didn't know that. Can you press X? Can you press something? Can we press E? Oh, we can. Now we are just falling out. And there's something down there. Do you see that? There is actually something going on there. Oh, but how can we get inside? Because I saw in the preview on Steam, there are actually a lot of more rooms here, and you can even see the president or something. So I really wanted to see that, but I think that is... that's probably a bunker or something. Maybe we shouldn't even see that. Oh, what is this? What is any of this? Okay, so far so good. Unfortunately, there's no way to restart the game, because there's no menu and buttons are not doing anything. So yeah, we crashed the game, let's restart it again, let's try to nuke something again. I was really hoping that we could set a target, though. So that's not an option, unfortunately. With R, we can raise T countdown. Doesn't do anything now. And something else. Fly helicopter. When presented with notification device. Mm-hmm. Then you see time to launch. From 17 seconds to 0. Hmm. Okay, that's a bit disappointing. So what are we gonna do then? Let me think. We could, we could enter that again. Maybe something. It looks so weird. But we can't move it anymore. So maybe if we press T? No. Y? Maybe R? Yeah, we can retract it again. And once retracted, we should be able to move around. Now it's suddenly so slow. Okay. Maybe we can retract it again. Maybe. Or not. Oh, we can. What is going on? Retract yourself. Fine. But there's no rocket inside. It's kind of pointless, isn't it? I was curious, can we still launch something? Maybe it's a bug. No, we can't. Anyway, let's restart the game. I'll be back in a moment. And welcome back. So the reviews are mixed. As you can imagine, there's not much going on in this game. But you know, I kinda expected something like... where is it? Something like... like here, complicated activation codes, or flying this plane, or even there's some photo of some sort of, I don't know, party meeting. Even source codes, so there must be a way to reach that somehow, and there's even an app. I don't think it's an actual app, but maybe an app inside the game. And what is this? Maybe it's not... there's no way I missed that. So let's just try again, let's try to look, see inside, maybe we'll find something. Find a way to reach it. Okay, everything's back to normal. You hear the great music in the background. Oh, and something explodes, which is totally normal. Yeah, I get it. Now, how can we get inside this room? It must be somewhere here. But before we do that, let's launch another nuke. Literally, let's launch it. Let's launch it outside. I think that is how it was supposed to go. Yes. Oh, invisible walls. What am I seeing there? Interesting. And then the map is supposedly quite big, so we can move around here and explore if we want, of course. Now let's not destroy this machine. It would cause trouble if we break it. Please stop. Right, it stopped. So we will race. Pressing R, we race. The thing. Yeah, that's a fast raising. Okay, so prepare to nuke somebody. Who are we gonna nuke? We're gonna nuke Germany. Yeah, that's a good target. And let's prepare all our codes. How do we launch that thing? I forgot. Maybe with T? T sounds like a good launch command. Yeah, that sounds good. Maybe we should have removed the head first, but I think it will be okay. It will be fine. So, Germany will be nuked today. Where is the activation code? Let's press it. Huawei is the activation code. Correct. And prepare to be nuked. 15. Okay, let's move far away so we can admire that whole situation. That's where I start. Oh, that looks... actually quite interesting. I wonder, is it actually based on the real Dangfang 41 or... wow, it's flying. It's actually flying. I mean, of course it's flying. Now, can we zoom into it? Let's just admire this thing. Ah, now we are zooming out for some reason? Which kind of makes sense, you know? Oh, that is a bug. So this is a reason, by the way. What exploded there? I don't know. But anyway, the reason the floor disappeared is because we switched to this camera perspective. Now, that's explained it. So the Germans are pissed that we're nuking them, but nothing they can do. And let's see, wait, what perspective is that even? Where's China? Oh, so we were probably in Inner Mongolia or somewhere. Now, where's the rocket flying to? It's quite fast, actually, because you would expect, you know, for such a long-range rocket, it takes something like, you know, 1 hour, what am I saying, maybe even 6 hours to reach anything, but that is a very fast rocket. Or a very small Earth. One of the two. And I will not press X, because the game will crash if I press X, presumably, like last time. And I want to know where it lands, I want to see the explosion, you know? Because I think there must be some sort of explosion, because... Or not. Okay, so there's no explosion, unfortunately. that's kind of an issue. And I want to know how to go down. Maybe there's some sort of elevator there. Seems like that. But there's probably no way for us to go there. Okay, let's restart the game again. And start it up. Preparing, launching. At least there's no annoying loading screen, which is also good. Now let's try something out. Have you already tried the helicopter? Oh, can we actually die here? Hopefully not. Now, we are flying. I was disoriented for a moment. Surprisingly, the controls are actually good. I've not expected that, but this is a really great helicopter control. Which is not necessarily something we would have expected. Now, how do we get down? There must be a way for us to get down. But how? I mean, underground. I want to see the bunker. Yeah, the music is amazing, but I think that we can just jump out of that at that point. We'll just jump out. And let's see. It was somewhere here, I think. It was somewhere here, must be the entry to that special area. Not here, though. I really don't know. And what's the point of this game, by the way, you're asking? And that is a very good question, because I thought we can actually nuke something, but I don't think we can. I think this is just a simulator for the device that shoots the missile. And that's kind of it. Maybe there are zombies here, I don't know. Maybe, I don't know, let's just run around and maybe we will discover something. This buildings there should be here for some reason, I think. There's literally nothing. And by the way, this Steam page said this is an undisclosed location in China. So we don't know where it is, which makes sense. You don't want your enemy to know where your missiles are. It would be otherwise kind of stupid if they would know that. There's literally no entry. I don't see it. Where is the bunker? Maybe it's not finished yet. That could be what's happening. Wait, I don't think we will find anything. I think that's it. And there's not much else to do here, unfortunately. I don't know. I have expected something more polished. But anyway, it was just released, you know. It's early access. And what do you expect? It's even free, you know. They don't even charge money for that. Now, that is something I have not seen. Oh, there's actually a plane here. Maybe now we can do some real Microsoft flight simulations. I really hope we can. There must be a way to enter that thing. Maybe if I press E close to it? Oh, what's going on? I kind of lost control there for a moment. What is this red thing? Yellow thing. No, there's no way to enter it. That's really, really sad. That would be so amazing. But no, we can't enter it. Only thing we can do is a helicopter, something blinking there, I don't know. And there's some war going on there in the background. That can't be good. I didn't even notice, but there's literally a war going on. We are in the war zone, we are being attacked. So that's maybe the reason why we are trying to nuke as fast as possible. And what is that? There's something flying in the air. That should probably not be here, I think. Yeah, definitely not. That's some sort of alien device. It shouldn't be here. Anyway, so that's it. Nothing more I can show, I think. That is Dangfang 41... What is that game again? It's simulation for DF41, yeah. That's basically it. And what you see is what you get. I mean, the Steam page is a bit misleading in that regard that it shows much more exciting imagery, but nothing to be found here. There's only this tank and the helicopter and that thing there. One thing, however, I am curious about one last thing before we end this. How would it look like if I actually stay on the ground? Let's test it out. So, I mean, I can shoot the missile while being on the ground, and maybe the everything will not glitch if I do that. Let's try it. T, not T, again, R. Yeah, R was it. Now, after pressing R, is there something else we can press? That was U and J. I don't know what they do. Can you zoom out? We can zoom out a bit, but it's a bit hard to zoom out. I want to see what's going on there. Yeah, exactly. So now if we press U. Oh, it just vanished. Okay. J. Oh, we should have probably. What? I have no idea what that was. Anyway, let's launch it. Huawei. No, incorrect. Huawei, I said. Many people don't know, but Huawei actually manufactures nuclear devices, nuclear missiles and stuff like that, not only mobile devices. I wouldn't even be surprised if they actually do that, because I know it's a big company and you must do what you must do. So... Alright, five seconds, and now it launched! And what I'm thinking, will we actually see some sort of explosion if we just stand here? Because last time we weren't able to, but maybe if we stay on the ground, maybe it will come back, I don't know. Okay, we won't see anything. But I'm curious about one thing. Can we actually follow the missile? We should be able to. If you're fast enough... I don't know how fast it's moving, but we should be... We could be able to. I think we reached this height. It will be... I don't think it's even remotely close. I think... Yeah. We're way too slow. We can't actually reach it. But anyway, this... I found this on the Steam store. It was marked as a sandbox. This was released 1 month ago, and there are very interesting gems you can find on Steam if you look for that. Was stuff like that. So anyway, that's it. That is Dangfang, whatever. Dangfang for one. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And I don't know. There doesn't seem to be anything more. What is that? If you press Alt on F2 while in game to start NVIDIA answer. Oh, you can even take screenshot if you want to. If you want to. And Shift enables to run while working. Super speed enabled to room map. With the 4-4 exit game. Okay, so that's that. So thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.